Judah Garcia. Chenante Bego Medfila, and I'm from deep south Santa Flora.
All right, perfect. All right, Judah, tell us about your younger days growing up in Santa Flora and when you first fell in love with the game of football.
My younger days was very enjoyable, very fun, you know, growing up with in a house of footballers only. You know, I always follow my brother when they go to training. We all started off with Cox Coaching School, where I really got the extra boost for the game and the enjoyment to play the game of football through Mr. Cox, you know, and after that I went into the Pro League and just went forward from there.
What was football life for you at Shiva Boys?
Shiva Boys was like a place like home, you know, to be honest. Everything they do is very together, like I love, like going in there at Form 1, they really groomed me into the senior team, so I'll say by Form 3 I was already starting on the team and being one of the top guys in the school league.
How has the secondary school's football league helped you in terms of you've been able to come out here and experience football outside of Trinidad and Tobago, but is there the system there? Did it help you into nurturing you into a player that can represent the country now, into the player you are? And do you think it has the right support system for other players coming up?
To be honest, with the sports maps and the coverage of cameras and everything, and the level of players and the level of the young players getting groomed to play in the colleges league, I'll say it's very good. And I wouldn't say it's up to the level of to be at international. I think more or less after the school league, I think a player should go right in to the Pro League to play a higher level, because the level out there is very fast and very high.
All right, tell us about that, because now you've seen it out here. We played the US and we've observing other teams, and you're seeing their players coming with a level of professionalism with the background at their clubs. What would you say to players who are trying to get into the mode for this sort of competition?
It's all about putting the extra work in. It's about going to the gym, putting in the hard work, going on the pitch every day, putting in the hard work, and do the extras also. Because the guys out there already growing up from a young age in the right program, which we do not have at Trinidad, to be honest. And I'll just say for the young guys, you know, to try their best to go in a gym and put in the extra work.
What has the influence of Levi and Nathaniel been like in your life?
To be honest, to see two of my older brothers being professionals, and it's an upliftment for me, and I just want to carry on their legacy and make my family proud.
Really, when you sit down and you think about what you've been through, you've seen Levi made it at the highest level as a youngster as well, and then you see the state of football in Trinidad and Tobago, and you know the capabilities, because you just spoke about the fact that we have players who are talented and they've been given a gift to play the game. What do you really think about where football is heading, and where would you like to see our football go?
To be honest, I will say my home, my country, is a very talented area. It's a very talented country. Most of our players are, to be honest, better than most of the other players outside. But what they are always beating us is with more development from a young age, and getting them into the gym, getting them to do extra work, and giving them the right sources from young growing up. And I think that is what Trinidad needs to do on their national team and the clubs. They need to get the right program and do everything more professional.
Away from the game, what is life like for you? What do you do to kind of take your mind off the game a bit and maybe to kind of get your mind ready for football?
I live in a very cool area, you know. We always get together, sweat, make a cook, you know. Sundays mostly is go to church, you know. We always give thanks to the Lord, because I came from a spiritual home and we always put God first.
What do you think about the environment back home now and you know, the crime situation? How do you deal with all these distractions?
Well, for me, my area is not a hotspot area, it's a cool area, but for the other areas, it's a very sad thing to see so many murders my country are having within a year and everything. But for the young players who are talented, I'll say just keep your head up and try to do the things to don't get you into the violence. And
what's a normal day for you in football and in the footballing world in terms of how do you prepare off season and during the season?
Off season, you know, gym work is the most important work in here right now, because you can have all the skill, all everything, but if you don't have the gym work and the actual muscles to finish on 90 minutes, it's nothing.
And on the training pitch, how often are you on the training pitch?
Basically every day, you know. Only like Sundays, I give myself a off day to go to church and to relax that day, and I just pick it up Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, and continue every day, every week.
What are your aspirations? Where do you see yourself within the next year or two?
The next year or two, I see myself in a club in Europe.
Any particular leagues that you're kind of earmarked?
Not any league in particular, but my utmost goal is to end up in Spain one day.
Being out here and you know, the three games we've played so far, what do you think about the way our team has performed, considering the limited preparation, and how do you see us faring for the rest of the competition?
To be honest, I'm very happy with my team performance, you know. A few scouts have told me, you know, in the St. Vincent game, that was one of the best games they saw in the tournament, because in less than 2 minutes, we came back and won a game. Coming into the Puerto Rico game, we had a very good game. It was tough for the USA game. You could see that USA was more organized and had a lot more training and a lot more exposure than us. And it showed up in the game that we didn't prepare enough for this tournament.
What is it like brushing shoulders, so to say, and being coached by somebody like Russell Atapi?
To be honest, he's a player's coach. You know, he makes you feel comfortable every session. He makes you feel comfortable in the game also. It's just a pleasure working under him.
Anybody that you want to make special mention of who've helped you in your life, in your career?
I'll go off by saying Mr. Cox. You know, I started off playing with him. After him, Mr. Anthony Sherwood, school, Dexter Francis, Sheldon Mirage, Hayden Ryan, and that's about it.
All right, perfect. Tell me a bit about, what you do to relax.
To relax, music. You know,
favorite type of music?
Say gospel and soca.
Gospel and soca. Favorite type of food?
Sunday lunch, pie, macaroni pie, stewed chicken, rice, kalalu.
Perfect. All right, Judah, all the best to you, and we look forward to seeing you again in the future.
Thank you.
Some of them just want easy living. Not success, reach them watching your things. So you wanna show?